white parents whose worst fear is a child with dyed hair and who likes earrings. Like whatever they say has no bearing. It's so scary in a house that allows no swearing to see him walking around with his headphones blaring, alone in his own zone, cold and he don't care. He's a problem child, and what bothers him all comes out when he talks about his fucking dad walking out. Cause he hates him so bad that he blocks him out. If he ever saw him again, he'd probably knock him out. His thoughts are whacked, he's mad, so he's talking back, talking black, brainwashed from rock and rap. He sacks his pants, blue rags and a stocking cap. His stepfather hit him, so he socked him back and broke his nose. His house is a broken home, there's no control, he just lets his emotions go. Sinner's mind is a sanctum, holy or unholy. Only have one homie, only this gun. Lonely, cause don't anyone know me. Yet everybody just feels like they can relate. I guess words are a motherfucker. They can be great, or they can degrade, or even worse, they can teach hate. It's like these kids hang on every single statement we make, like they worship us, plus all the stores ship us platinum. Now how the fuck did this metamorphosis happen? From standing on corners and porches just rapping to having a fortune, no more kissing ass. But then these critics crucify you, journalists try to burn you, fans turn on you, attorneys all gonna turn it to get their hands on every dime you have. They want you to lose your mind every time you mad, so they can try to make you out to look like a loose cannon. Any dispute won't hesitate to produce handguns. That's why these prosecutors wanna convict me, strictly just to get me off of these streets quickly. But all they kids be listening to me religiously, so I'm signing CDs while police fingerprint me. They're for the judge's daughter, but his grudge is against me. If I'm such a fucking menace, this shit doesn't make sense, B. It's all political. If my music is literal and I'm a criminal, how the fuck can I raise a little girl? I couldn't, I wouldn't be fit to. You're full of shit too, Guerrera. That was a fist that hit you. It was my fault, and I'll get sued. See what these kids do, hear about us toting pistols, and they wanna get one, cause they think the shit's cool. Not knowing we really just protecting ourselves, we entertainers. Of course the shit's affecting ourselves, you ignoramus. But music is reflection of self, we just explain it, and then we get our checks in the mail. It's fucked up, ain't it? How we can come from practically nothing to being able to have any fucking thing that we wanted. That's why we sing for these kids who don't have a thing, except for a dream and a fucking rat magazine, who post pinup pictures on their walls all day long, idolize their favorite rappers and know all their songs. Or for anyone who's ever been through shit in their lives, do they sit and they cry at night wishing they died? Do they throw on a rap record and they sit and they vibe with nothing to you but with the fucking shit in their eyes? That's why we seize the moment, try to freeze it and own it, squeeze it and hold it, cause we consider these minutes golden. And maybe they'll admit it when we're gone. Just let our spirits live on through our lyrics that you hear in our songs, and we can sing.
In the first verse, Eminem discusses how his music is not meant for the general audience, but for one specific person who needs it the most. He calls out the parents, especially white parents, who fear their sons acting like Eminem or like any rapper. The child has Eminem's signature dyed hair and pierced ears and is meant to symbolize the kids that relate to Eminem's music. He talks about how he is emotionally in control of himself and how he needs to let it go. In the second verse, Eminem shifts gears and begins to talk about his current life. He says that he's surrounded by danger, negativity, and pain, and he feels like he needs to defend himself, but that he is also isolated from other people. He reinforces the idea that his songs are not meant to be taken deeply by the people that don't relate to them. Then, he talks about his transformation from being a kid who rapped for fun to being a worldwide sensation. He moves on to talk about how the media crucifies him and how they make him look like a loose cannon. Finally, he references how his critics think that he is unfit to be a father. The first four lines of the third verse are a hyperbole for the effect that music has on its listeners. Eminem says that rappers glorify guns and how they think that owning them is cool without looking at the risks. Then he says that his music is just a reflection of himself and that he's only explaining his life. He says that because he came from nothing, he owes it to the kids that don't have anything, just like he did, to perform and make a life out of what he loves. In the chorus, Eminem is inspiring his listeners to, quote, sing for the moment and make music while it's worth it and while people will listen to it. Subject: rich beyond his wildest dreams, but always the subject of media beefs and feuds, this song deserves a therapeutic tirade against those who blame Eminem and his rap counterparts for the negative ideas and actions of the current generation. In the first verse, Eminem describes a typical home situation in which the children return proactively and overtly propagandistic rap music. In the second verse, Eminem describes how although many rappers came from humble beginnings, the deep and meaningful music fuels the media into transforming their image into one filled with drugs, crime, and violence. In the third verse, Eminem addresses the hypocrisy associated with accusations against rap music, ruining the generation, and explains how the music he makes is not for those who criticize it, but for the people who need it most. His music is for the people who are growing up like he did, and Eminem serves as a model for them, a light through their difficult years. Occasion: Eminem, during this time, is the most popular rapper in the market. At this time, he receives constant criticism by many for taking a generally black music genre and popularizing it with suburban Caucasian children. As a result, much of his music made during the time was angry, yet poignant and focused on a certain aspect of his life. For example, some would argue that Eminem was leaving his prime after the commercial success of the Slim Shady LP and the Marshall Mathers LP. There was no way he could continue, and so came the song Till I Collapse. Audience: this piece is a slanderous diatribe against the media critics of his music. He was even the subject of a congressional hearing. It is clear that he is talking to those in the media and those in positions of power, explaining, albeit angrily, that his message is not meant for you, so stop slandering his name. Purpose: the purpose of the song is, in the words of Eminem himself, "I don't care if you are listening, because he's listening. That's who I'm directing my material at. It does not matter what the so-called important people think about him and his music, but if he can break through to one kid, that's all that matters." He echoes a similar sentiment in his 2013 song, Rap God. Speaker: Eminem is the speaker/artist of this song. At this point in 2002, Eminem is at the peak of his fame, both in sales and controversy. Although mostly speaking for himself, especially with the last line of the second verse mentioning a personal situation with his ex-wife, it is clear that Eminem is using his large platform to tell the media that they are spreading these false images of rappers. This is especially the case of rappers who try to speak earnestly and spread a message to the public. In this case, Eminem holds the entire genre of rap on his shoulders. Tone: Eminem adopts a very angry tone during the course of this song, but there is also a sense of vulnerability in his voice. He is angry that he is perceived as a drug-addicted murderer, but he is more angry at the fact that the media scrutiny has prevented his music from reaching the kids who need it most. A real F-U attitude to those who spread this false image. Also known for his rhyme scheme and lyrical ability, Eminem's second verse on the song is one of his most rhythmic, with less than 20 syllables in the verse, not in the rhyme scheme.